So now that we know how to graph the parent function for the absolute value, y equals the absolute value of x, let's start exploring some different ones. How about if we add a constant a in front of the absolute value of x? So if we're approached with a situation where we have to graph y equals some constant times the absolute value of x, here's what we do. This constant a tells us a lot about the graph. If the absolute value of a is greater than 1, then the graph's going to be narrower than the parent function. Now, if the absolute value of a is less than 1, the graph's going to be wider than the parent function. So let's graph a few examples. Let's start with y equals 3 times the absolute value of x. Now in this case, a is 3. And since 3's absolute value is greater than 1, we expect we're going to have a graph that's narrower than the parent function. Let's plug some points and see what it will be. When x equals 0, 0 times 3 is 0. So we have the coordinate 0, 0. When x equals 2, the absolute value of 2 is 2. So 2 times 3 is 6. So we have 2, 6. 1, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. How about when x equals negative 1. When x equals negative 1, the absolute value of negative 1 is 1. 1 times 3 is 3, so we have the point negative 1, 3. When we connect these points, we can see that the graph is narrower than the parent function. Let's try a different one. How about y equals 1/2 times the absolute value of x? In this case, our a has an absolute value that is smaller than 1. So we're going to expect a graph that's wider. Let's try x equals 0. When x equals 0, 0 times 1/2 is 0, so we have the point 0, 0. When x equals 2, 2 times 1/2 is 1, we have the point 2, 1. How about when x equals negative 4? Negative 4's absolute value is 4, times 1/2 we have 2, so we have the point negative 4, 2. Let's look at one last situation where we encounter a negative a. What if we have to graph y equals negative 3 times the absolute value of x? Now this is interesting. These two are very, very similar. The only thing that's different is this little negative. So we would expect these graphs to be very similar, except for one small thing. You do everything you did here, and then at the last second, you multiply it by negative 1, and so you end up with all negative y's. What happens is, the graph of y equals negative 3 times the absolute value of x is actually a reflection of the graph y equals 3 times the absolute value of x. So this blue graph here, if we reflect it down across the x-axis, we get the graph we're looking for. If you don't want to use the reflection method, you can plug in points. You'll end up with the same result.